Americans starting to phase into reopening, and myself and all my dental colleagues are preparing to reopen our dental practices. That should be coming up soon for us, close as next week. And I thought now more than ever is an important time to talk about the age one dental visit and why this is gonna be important for your child if you have an infant, to make sure that they stay healthy as we kind of enter dentistry post coronavirus pandemic. And so just as a quick introduction, my name is Dr. Laila Hishaw. I'm a board certified pediatric dentist. I'm a national speaker. I am author of Cavity-Free Kids, How to Care for Your Kids' Teeth from Birth Through Their Teenage Years. And I am a mother of three. So I wrote the book to share my practical tips and my dental experience to help parents raise happy, healthy kids, starting with their smile. And if you've been with me through these series that we did in April, with we coined the term Mondays with the Mommy Dentist, I've been sharing a few things while our kids have been homebound, and we have just had entered this whole new normalcy, if you call it that, you know, kids being home. I know we started off in the first week in April talking about the kids snacking, unscheduled snacking, the types of snacks that could cause some issues for them, so that I didn't want you going back into your dental office and your child having a lot of cavities from eating refined carbs such as the Goldfish crackers and chips and things like that, getting them on a schedule, making sure their routines haven't changed so much, making sure they're brushing the morning before they go to bed and flossing before they go to bed, making sure their water intake is regular and often. And we also talked 1 week again on how to handle some dental emergencies, what to do if filling fell out and you had to temporize it with a little temporary dental materials that you could do at home, how to handle dental emergencies should they fall down or fracture a tooth, and when to call the dentist to come in for an emergency. Last week we talked about our cute little toddlers and what they're facing as they're struggling to let you brush. I guess you're struggling to brush sometimes. Not all toddlers are as cooperative as some can be. I can attest to that. But today I wanted to talk about the age one dental visit. We call this the dental home in the American Academy of Pediatric Dentistry, our academy, as well as the American Academy of Pediatrics, which is your pediatrician's academy, recommend that your child be seen after their first teeth erupt by their first birthday. And the reason for this is because of prevention. We have seen recently an increase in tooth decay in children ages 2 to 5. And if we can get to them early enough, we can share some tips, some counseling with the families when they come into the dental practice on how to prevent cavities. And not only would that help your child, it also helps with your healthcare costs, so you're not paying costly amounts for restorations and crowns and sedations and stuff like this. And so as we, as dentists, are preparing to open the practice, I have had some concerns from parents of, how do I know it's safe to bring my child back to the dentist? You know, we have all been worried with this airborne virus of COVID-19, and the reason dental offices have been grouped in the medical field as far as closing down for elective treatment is because a lot of our work that we do, even cleanings, can produce those aerosols. And it's the aerosols that linger in the air and can carry this virus from person to person. So it was important that dentists close their office to mitigate the spread of coronavirus, not only for the protection of you and your family, but also for the dentists and their team and their families. So right now, what's happening until you should start to hear from your dental offices and your child's dental offices, but we are making sure we have the PPEs, the personal protective equipment that's required for us and our teams, those are really to protect the team us more so. Of course, we want our parents will be able to do things as far as screening before we have you come in. They're expect to have some questions asked over the phone, expect to see some changes in the waiting areas as far as how many people will be allowed to be in the reception area, how many people can be accompanying the child who's getting the dental treatment. It may be that your dentist will recommend only the child being treated that day come in. Perhaps you may have to wait with a sibling in the car. So this is gonna be at the discretion of your dentist. But just know that they are working hard. We are working to make sure we have something in place to protect not only you, but our team. So let's talk about the age one dental visit. So as I shared, in past talks, we said that we've learned the statistic that about more than half of children will have decay by the age of 5 if not seen by a dentist early. So when I bring up seeing the dentist early or as early as age 1, a lot of parents are like, there's no way they're going to sit in a dental chair. Why would I bring my child that early? And we don't expect them to sit in the chair. I'm going to show you a picture of a knee-to-knee exam that is done with the dentist and the parent. But it really does serve that time that we can give you a list of what to expect. We call this anticipatory guidance. When the teeth should be coming in, what happens sometimes as the tooth is getting loose and how you can help it out. We get a chance to demonstrate proper toothbrushing and flossing, even though they don't have their molars in the back, but we get to show you if the teeth are close together, how to use those floss sticks and how to brush and how to set up a regimen at home that will take with them as they grow up. So we'll talk about brushing instructions. We also get to really get in there and talk about diet. As you know, I'm really big on diet. If I have siblings and one sibling like never brushes but has the best diet and not eating chips and gummy fruit snacks and kind of grazing and snacking all day, the kiddo who doesn't brush and eats all that, the one who has the worst diet is going to have the cavities, even if, let's say, they're not the best at brushing, if that makes any sense. So we, at that first visit, we get to make sure that the parents are, that first year of life, they should be exclusively just breastfed or having formula. And after 6 months, they can have about 4 ounces of water, but no juice should be introduced at that first year of life. After 1, you can have the recommended ounces of juice based on what your pediatrician is recommending, but we will say a 100% juice, not the juice boxes, okay? So in that visit again, so we've talked about hygiene, we've talked about diet, we'll talk about their growth and development, how their jaw is developing, what can happen from, a common question I get is, when do I have to take away the pacifier? Should I be worried that they're sucking their thumb? And that first year, we're going to say, it's okay. We're not worried about it. We really want habits like these to wean off by age 2. But then also, we can talk about trauma. What would happen if they fell down and bumped their tooth? When is it the time to call the dentist to discuss things? But also, we get to talk about things that most of your parents already know on child safety and watching the cords and outlets and making sure they're covered because some are early walkers and they're not so balanced on their feet. And so we do see emergencies when kids fall down and injure their teeth, their lips, their mouth, their tongue. And then we'll also discuss fluoride. Fluoride is one of the best things we can do to help strengthen the enamel, to make the teeth more resistant to the challenges of acid from sugar and candy and acid in juice and sodas. And fluoride will work to help remineralize spots of cavities that are just starting, some weaker spots. So your dentist will talk about how much, which we say is smear, right-sized amount of fluoride toothpaste to brush with at home. And we'll also would recommend a fluoride varnish in the dental office. And I wanted to also share, I forgot, in the book, and also on the mommydentist.com. I have a first dental visit checklist on what you can be looking towards to expect at the dental visit, what to plan in advance. You know, one of the things is, where do you go for to find a pediatric dentist? And general dentists will see kids as well. We just want to make sure that your general dentist sees kids at their first birthday. It's their preference if they want to wait till they're three. That's how they are managing and want to have their practice on a certain age level. That's totally fine, but you should be seen by age one. So you might want to see keep searching by asking your referral sources, ask your pediatrician, or ask a friend who they take their child to. And then you can also go online at the American Academy of Pediatric Dentistry, so it's aapd.org, and there's a find a dentist button that you can put in your zip code and find it, because 70% of pediatric dentists will recommend that it should be seen by first birthday. I should say 70% in the United States have been surveyed that they are seeing them by age one. So, and then also in this form, I just talk about things that can help you along. You should definitely do all you can, and this is going to go for everyone's dental visit, yours included. Whatever forms are available online, download those at home so you can fill them out at the comforts of your home, get everything done. This is gonna decrease the time that you're having to wait in the reception area, because remember, we're just not wanting a lot of people hanging around to respect the social distancing and keep everyone safe. So do all the paperwork you can. Plus, imagine you have your infant and maybe in your and perhaps you have a toddler, and to try to fill out all that paperwork while watching the other kiddo can kind of lose your focus. And so we want things to go quickly and smoothly. Also, just be prepared with some questions you want to ask your dentist. I know for myself, once I'm in there and with all the excitement of everything's going on and pictures are being taken of their first dental visit, that sometimes we forget to ask those questions we really wanted to know. Ask the questions of, what should I do if there's a dental emergency? Is there a specific phone number we need to call your office, or how can I reach you? Is there a pager number? You ask him about the fluoride, or ask him when x-rays are going to be required as he ages. So any of those questions, or even if you need a tip, let's say you have been trying to brush and it's just been so hard, so you can have those questions ready so they can answer them for you. And then at the dental visit, I did want to show you in the book, this is here, the Kindle version, this is the knee-to-knee exam. So sometimes, like you said, a parent will say, well, there's no way they're going to sit in the chair. They're going to be nervous, or they're just going to be fidgety. But you can have the parent holding the child in their lap facing them. So I would say, okay, you're going to give mommy a hug with your legs, and mom's just going to hold them in their arms like this. And the dentist will sit across from them. And then the child lays back into the dentist's lap. And this helps us to see really well because, like, you know, they're moving around. So the better we see, the quicker the exam will go and the more thorough the exam will be. Plus, having the child holding the hands, I don't know if you can see well. Well, Violet is holding her mom's hands right there. She sees her mom. Her mom actually can get a better view of what I'm showing her when I give her some tips on how I want her to brush, how to lift up the lip to get around the gum line, how to brush your tongue. And so that's just very, very helpful for them when we're doing the exam in that fashion. And as I've said before in our last live, that actually just doing that position at home when you're brushing can help. We talked about with the toddler session, that's right, that sometimes you can, after bath time, swaddle them up in a towel, have them lay down on your lap and brush that way, or on the bed or on the changing table. So I really, really want to get that message across that now more than ever, we want to not have to do dental procedures that will produce an aerosol, okay? And of course, the main thing is we want your child to be healthy and happy, and if they are cavity free, that really helps. So This prevention of getting in early is so key that I really want parents to kind of just throw away that mindset of they're just too little, they're just baby teeth. That is false. They need those baby teeth till they're between the ages of 10 and 12. The baby molars do not come out till they're between the ages of 10 and 12. And so I think some of the reasons why some parents haven't brought their child this early, because a recent survey showed that about 75% of parents know or feel that dental care and oral health is very important to their child, but 75% didn't bring their child in to the dentist by age one. And there's so many things going on. You know, as a new mom, there you have a list of things you have to do, the checkups, the vaccinations, and just learning to be a new mom and everything that goes with it, that sometimes that just gets pushed back on the back burner. But I know that even with you just being here, your goal is to raise healthy, healthy children. And overall health is encompassed with every part of us, and definitely oral health is an integral part of their overall health. So I think that is pretty much all. Just remember on the brushing and flossing to use a smeared amount of fluoride. It is safe for an infant. We recommend it by their first birthday to start with the fluoride paste. And also just try to just push out the juice as long as possible. Really, honestly, even beyond 2 and 3. If they're gonna have juice, make it 100%. And the thing is, your child, even though this is easier said than done, but if you have whatever you have available in the pantry or in the refrigerator, they're gonna want. So when you're shopping, just don't get juice boxes. You can get the 100% juice, but that first year of life, if I could just implore one thing, is just keep it to breast milk and formula and water after 6 months, just that first year of life. And that's really going to make a huge difference. I see so much decay from juice because the acid in the juice, and it's the sugar and the acid, demineralizes, weakens the enamel between the teeth. And when you see cavities in between the teeth, that's where the juice has been splashing on the teeth, has been bathing the teeth, and that acid breaks down the enamel. So the key thing here is watch what they're drinking and getting them in by their first birthday. So I'm just gonna see if there are any questions. And of course, if you're catching this on the replay, go ahead and put your questions in the comments, and I'll definitely hang out there and answer all that I can. I think I see anything. What else did I want to say? Yes, you can download the first dental visit checklist on how to plan, how to have a smooth appointment, and also the questions to ask your dentist. This is on our website, themommydentist.com. Again, themommydentist.com. We'll upload it to Facebook as well, so you can get a link that directs you to the download for free, for free, for free, for free. Okay, and our stories today, look for my favorites in my kits that are on the Mommy Dentist website that is broken down by age group. And so we have a infant oral health kit of things that I have tried or my parents have tried and that work great for them. And then there's links to check them out if you're interested. But I wish you guys all well, stay healthy. I know for me, I'm very excited to see my patients again and get back into the practice. I hope everyone's been taking care of their teeth so we can just go back to cleanings and not a whole bunch of fillings, and I wish that for you. Please feel free to reach out. We'll continue to post tips in our Facebook page and our Instagram. And of course, don't forget to check out the book, Cavity Free Kids, How to Care for Your Kids' Teeth from Birth Through Their Teenage Years. It's been a pleasure meeting with you guys on Facebook Live, and you can always reach out to me if you have specific questions. So smile always, guys. Thank you so much. Take care.